Good day and God bless you. Welcome to the Bible reading in chronological order. Just such a privilege to have you with us once again. And I want to thank you for joining. I want to thank you for participating with us in this venture, for really going through the Word of God with us. It's such a blessing to be able to do this with and for you. And I pray that the Lord would really just speak to us through His Word today. Today we're busy in the first book of the Chronicles, and we're going to close out the book today. So we're going to be doing chapters 26, 27, 28, and 29. And then we're going to go through one psalm as well, namely Psalm 127. So let's get straight into it. Chapter 26 continues on from the previous chapters that we've gone through in the book of 1 Chronicles, in which David is setting up the order for the temple of the Lord. And in this chapter, we see that the divisions of the porters are stipulated. The gates are assigned by lot. And then King David sets Levites in charge of the treasures that were won in battle and dedicated to the Lord from the time of Samuel until the time that he gives this designation. David assigns officers and judges over the tribes on the other side of Jordan. Now, this is very important because you can think that David is ruler of this kingdom of Israel, but there's one set of people on the other side of Jordan. There's the set of people that he's ruling over here, and that gives him a bit of a logistical nightmare in terms of his politics, and they could always just break free and want to abdicate from the kingdom. So it was important for David then to set up from a political standpoint, but also from a religious standpoint, to set up officers and judges over the tribes on the other side of Jordan. So just remember that. Then when you're reading it, it seems strange that it would only mention those tribes that had officers and judges over it. Remember then, it's because they were the other side of Jordan. Then we get to chapter 27. And in here we see that David sets captains over each monthly course and designates 12 princes, one over each tribe of the children of Israel. So we see now in chapter 27 that David assigns one prince over each tribe, and that's good, and so that would manage those tribes. Those are like state governors or something like that. It is a good way to manage everything and to be over everything and then get feedback from these princes. Then David also sets officers over his treasury. Now, when we look at the way in which David divided the officers and the officers of the house of the Lord, we see that he took an extreme amount of care to abide by the law given by Moses. This wasn't a short planning phase. It wasn't a short preparation. This took real serious dedication and time to be able to set these things up. He looked. The sons of Korah needed to be doing this. The other Levites needed to be doing that. And the other Levites needed to be doing this. And so David draws it up and he sets it up and he makes sure that he abides within the laws. And certain things that were ambiguous, then they cast lots and ask the Lord to show them through the lots what needs to happen in certain places. So this was a very long process if you think about it properly. This was David basically setting up everything. And especially the house of the Lord, the temple, would be the essence of the entire nation of Israel. It would be the central focus of the children of Israel. And so when he designated all of these things, he took extreme amount of care and time. Then we get to chapter 28. And here we see that David assembles all of the office bearers to Jerusalem, and he exhorts the people to fear the Lord. He declares the word of the Lord that the prophet had given him, that Solomon was to build the temple of the Lord and to be king over Israel. And then he encourages Solomon. Tell Solomon to be brave, to be of good courage, to rule the people well, to fear the Lord, to serve the Lord in his reign. And then we see the chapter sort of ends with an account of the treasury for the specific purposes that were given. Then we get to chapter 29, and in chapter 29, David encourages the princes and the people to offer for the house of God, and they do so with a willing heart. It's so beautiful when we see that. David is saying, I have given this much. And then he says, all of the people of Israel, you can give as well. And then it says, and they gave with a willing heart. That is such a blessing. Then David gives thanks to the Lord and acknowledges in amazement that he gets an opportunity to worship and praise and live for the living God. This is something that we often get wrong in our lives. We think we have to serve the Lord. We have to keep the law. We have to do this. No. David's attitude toward this, as he prays and he gives thanks to the Lord, he says, I can't believe that the living God would allow me to worship him, would show his face toward me, would actually have my people as his own. What an opportunity that is. What a gracious thing that is. I want to give my all for you because you have accepted us and you didn't need to. That's the heart of David. And man, oh man, if we can have that same heart. Then we're given a summary of David's reign and then his death is described. Lastly, we're going to go through Psalm chapter 127. And this is a psalm describing the vanity of human endeavors without God's blessing. The Lord declares that children are his gift to his people and he gives his beloved sleep. Now this, in our age, these are not progressive themes. Children are a gift? No. In our age, we don't want children. In fact, we are very prone to killing off children as best as we can. The psalm says that he gives his beloved sleep. In our age, we say sleep is bad. Work harder. Do more. Don't worry about that. And so these are not progressive themes. In fact, in our age, we chase after wealth and good careers. We look for independence. We look for our human rights or our personal rights more than family and community. And this is difficult, and it's the truth, unfortunately. And yet the Lord, he blesses his children with sleep, with good health. He blesses his children with children. He builds the community. He looks after the community. And then we see that he talks about this rest, this peace, this comfort. And in the New Testament, when we get to that, these are not just physical things, but this is a type of the Holy Spirit. And so when we look for the baptism of the Holy Ghost, what is that? That is the peace of God. That is the rest wherewith he caused the weary to rest. I'm going to leave it there. I pray that the Lord would bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he give you peace. God bless you as you enjoy the reading of the word today.
Chapter 26. Concerning the divisions of the porters. Of the Korahites was Meshelemiah, the son of Kori, of the sons of Asaph. And the sons of Meshelemiah were Zechariah the firstborn, Jediel the second, Zebadiah the third, Jathniel the fourth, Elam the fifth, Jehohanan the sixth, Elioenai the seventh. Moreover, the sons of Obed-Edom were Shemaiah the firstborn, Jehozadab the second, Joah the third, and Sachar the fourth, and Nethaneel the fifth, Amiel the sixth, Issachar the seventh, Pealthi the eighth, for God blessed him. Also unto Shemaiah his son were sons born that ruled throughout the house of their father, for they were mighty men of valor. The sons of Shemaiah, Othni, and Rephael, and Obed, Elzabad, whose brethren were strong men, Elihu, and Semachiah. All these of the sons of Obed-Edom, they and their sons and their brethren, able men for strength for the service, were 72 of Obed-Edom. And Meshelemiah had sons and brethren, strong men, 18. Also Hosa of the children of Merari had sons. Simri the chief, for though he was not the firstborn, yet his father made him the chief. Hilkiah the second, Tebaliah the third, Zechariah the fourth. All the sons and brethren of Hosa were 13. Among these were the divisions of the porters, even among the chief men, having wards one against another to minister in the house of the Lord. And they cast lots, as well the small as the great, according to the house of their fathers, for every gate. And the lot eastward fell to Shelemiah. Then for Zechariah his son, a wise counselor, they cast lots, and his lot came out northward, to Obed-Edom southward, and to his sons, the house of Asaphim. To Shuppim and Hosa the lot came forth westward, with the gate Shalaketh by the causeway of the going up, ward against ward. Eastward were 6 Levites, northward 4 a day, southward 4 a day, and toward Asaphim 2 and 2. At Parbar westward, 4 at the causeway, and 2 at Parbar. These are the divisions of the porters among the sons of Kori and among the sons of Merari. And of the Levites, Ahijah was over the treasures of the house of God, and over the treasures of the dedicated thing. As concerning the sons of Laodan, the sons of the Gershonite Laodan, chief fathers even of Laodan the Gershonite, were Jehieli. The sons of Jehieli, Zethan, and Joel his brother, which were over the treasures of the house of the Lord. Of the Amramites and the Izharites, the Hebronites and the Uzielites, and Shebuel, the son of Gershom, the son of Moses, was ruler of the treasures. And his brethren by Eliezer, Rehabiah his son, and Jeshiah his son, and Joram his son, and Zichri his son, and Shalomith his son, which Shalomith and his brethren were over all the treasures of the dedicated things, which David the king and the chief fathers, the captains over thousands and hundreds, and the captains of the host had dedicated. Out of the spoils won in battles did they dedicate to maintain the house of the Lord. And all that Samuel the seer, and Saul the son of Kish, and Abner the son of Ner, and Joab the son of Zeruiah had dedicated, and whosoever had dedicated anything, it was under the hand of Shalomith and of his brethren. Of the Izharites, Kenaniah and his sons were for the outward business over Israel, for officers and judges. And of the Hebronites, Hashabiah and his brethren, men of valor, 1,700, were officers among them of Israel on this side Jordan, westward, in all the business of the Lord and in the service of the king. Among the Hebronites was Jerijah the chief, even among the Hebronites, according to the generations of his fathers. In the 40th year of the reign of David, they were sought for, and there were found among them mighty men of valor at Jazer of Gilead. And his brethren, men of valor, were 2,700 chief fathers, whom King David made rulers over the Reubenites, the Gadites, and the half-tribe of Manasseh, for every matter pertaining to God and affairs of the king. Chapter 27. Now the children of Israel, after their number, to wit, the chief fathers and captains of thousands and hundreds, and their officers that served the king in any matter of the courses which came in and went out month by month throughout all the months of the year, of every course were 24,000. Over the first course for the first month was Jashabiam the son of Zabdiel, and in his course were 24,000. Of the children of Perez was the chief of all the captains of the host for the first month. And over the course of the second month was Dodai an Ahohite, and of his course was Mikloth also the ruler. In his course likewise were 24,000. The third captain of the host for the third month was Benaiah the son of Jehoiada, a chief priest, and in his course were 24,000. This is that Benaiah who was mighty among the 30 and above the 30, and in his course was Amizabad his son. The fourth captain for the fourth month was Asahel the brother of Joab, and Zebediah his son after him, and in his course were 24,000. The fifth captain for the fifth month was Shamhath the Izrahite, and in his course were 24,000. The sixth captain for the sixth month was Ira the son of Ikesh the Tekoite, and in his course were 24,000. The seventh captain for the seventh month was Helez the Pelonite of the children of Ephraim, and in his course were 24,000. The eighth captain for the eighth month was Sibbekai the Hushathite of the Zarhites, and in his course were 24,000. The ninth captain for the ninth month was Abiezer the Anatothite of the Benjamites, and in his course were 24,000. The tenth captain for the tenth month was Meharai the Netophathite of the Zarhites, and in his course were 24,000. The 11th captain for the 11th month was Benaiah the Pirathonite of the children of Ephraim, and in his course were 24,000. The 12th captain for the 12th month was Heldai the Netophathite of Othniel, and in his course were 24,000. Furthermore, over the tribes of Israel, the ruler of the Reubenites was Eliezer the son of Zichri, of the Simeonites, Shephatiah the son of Maacah, of the Levites, Hashabiah the son of Kemuel, of the Aaronites, Zadok, of Judah, Elihu, one of the brethren of David, of Issachar, Amri, the son of Michael, of Zebulun, Ishmaiah, the son of Obadiah, of Naphtali, Jerimoth, the son of Azrael, of the children of Ephraim, Hoshea, the son of Azaziah, of the half-tribe of Manasseh, Joel, the son of Pedaiah, of the half-tribe of Manasseh in Gilead, Iddo, the son of Zechariah, of Benjamin, Jaasiel, the son of Abner, of Dan, Azareel, the son of Jeroham. These were the princes of the tribes of Israel. But David took not the number of them from 20 years old and under, because the Lord had said he would increase Israel like to the stars of the heavens. Joab, the son of Zeruiah, began to number, but he finished not, because there fell wrath for it against Israel. Neither was the number put in the account of the chronicles of King David. And over the king's treasures was Asmaveth, the son of Adiel. and over the storehouses in the fields and the cities and in the villages and in the castles was Jehonathan, the son of Uzziah. And over them that did the work of the field for tillage of the ground was Ezri the son of Kelub. And over the vineyards was Shimei the Ramathite. Over the increase of the vineyards for the wine cellars was Zabdi the Shiphmite. And over the olive trees and the sycamore trees that were in the low plains was Baal-Hanan the Gederite. And over the cellars of oil was Joash. And over the herds that fed in Sharon was Shitrei the Sharonite. And over the herds that were in the valleys was Shaphat the son of Adlai. Over the camels also was Obil the Ishmaelite. And over the asses was Jediah the Meronathite. And over the flocks was Jazez the Hagirite. All these were the rulers of the substance which was King David's. Also Jonathan, David's uncle, was a counselor, a wise man, and a scribe. And Jehiel, the son of Hachmoni, was with the king's son. And Ahithophel was the king's counselor, and Hushai the Archite was the king's companion. And after Ahithophel was Jehoiada, the son of Benaiah, and Abiathar. And the general of the king's army was Joab. Chapter 28. And David assembled all the princes of Israel, the princes of the tribes, and the captains of the companies that ministered to the king by course, and the captains over the thousands, and captains over the hundreds, and the stewards over all the substance and possession of the king, and of his sons, with the officers, and with the mighty men, and with all the valiant men, unto Jerusalem. Then David the king stood up upon his feet and said,
Hear me, my brethren and my people. As for me, I had in mine heart to build an house of rest for the ark of the covenant of the Lord, and for the footstool of our God, and had made ready for the building. But God said unto me, Thou shalt not build an house for my name, because thou hast been a man of war, and hast shed blood. Howbeit the Lord God of Israel chose me before all the house of my father to be king over Israel forever. For he hath chosen Judah to be the ruler. And of the house of Judah, the house of my father, and among the sons of my father, he liked me to make me king over all Israel. And of all my sons, for the Lord hath given me many sons, he hath chosen Solomon my son, to sit upon the throne of the kingdom of the Lord over Israel. And he said unto me, Solomon thy son, he shall build my house and my courts, for I have chosen him to be my son, and I will be his father. Moreover, I will establish his kingdom forever, if he be constant to do my commandments and my judgments as at this day. Now therefore, in the sight of all Israel, the congregation of the Lord, and in the audience of our God, keep and seek for all the commandments of the Lord your God, that ye may possess this good land, and leave it for an inheritance for your children after you forever. And thou, Solomon my son, know thou the God of thy father, and serve him with a perfect heart, and with a willing mind. For the Lord searcheth all hearts, and understandeth all the imaginations of the thoughts. If thou seek him, he will be found of thee, but if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off forever. Take heed now, for the Lord hath chosen thee to build an house for the sanctuary. Be strong and do it.
Then David gave to Solomon his son the pattern of the porch, and of the houses thereof, and of the treasuries thereof, and of the upper chambers thereof, and of the inner parlors thereof, and of the place of the mercy seat, and the pattern of all that he had by the Spirit of the courts of the house of the Lord, and of all the chambers round about, of the treasuries of the house of God, and of the treasuries of the dedicated things. Also for the courses of the priests and the Levites, and for all the work of the service of the house of the Lord, and for all the vessels of service in the house of the Lord. He gave of gold by weight for things of gold, for all instruments of all manner of service, silver also for all instruments of silver by weight, for all instruments of every kind of service. Even the weight for the candlesticks of gold and for their lamps of gold, by weight for every candlestick and for the lamps thereof. And for the candlesticks of silver by weight, both for the candlestick and also for the lamps thereof, according to the use of every candlestick. And by weight he gave gold for the tables of showbread for every table, and likewise silver for the tables of silver. Also pure gold for the flesh hooks and the bowls and the cups. And for the golden basins he gave gold by weight for every basin, and likewise silver by weight for every basin of silver. And for the altar of incense, refined gold by weight, and gold for the pattern of the chariot of the cherubims that spread out their wings and covered the ark of the covenant of the Lord. All this, said David, the Lord made me understand in writing by his hand upon me, even all the works of this pattern. And David said to Solomon his son,
Be strong and of good courage, and do it. Fear not, nor be dismayed, for the Lord God, even my God, will be with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee, until thou hast finished all the work for the service of the house of the Lord. And behold, the courses of the priests and the Levites, even they shall be with thee for all the service of the house of God. And there shall be with thee for all manner of workmanship every willing, skillful man, for any manner of service. Also the princes and all the people will be holy at thy commandment.
Chapter 29. Furthermore, David the king said unto all the congregation,
Solomon, my son, whom alone God hath chosen, is yet young and tender, and the work is great. For the palace is not for man, but for the Lord God. Now I have prepared with all my might for the house of my God the gold for things to be made of gold, and the silver for things of silver, and the brass for things of brass, the iron for things of iron, and wood for things of wood, onyx stones, and stones to be set, glistering stones, and of diverse colors, and all manner of precious stones and marble stones in abundance. Moreover, because I have set my affection to the house of my God, I have of mine own proper good of gold and silver, which I have given to the house of my God, over and above all that I have prepared for the holy house, even 3,000 talents of gold, of the gold of Ophir, and 7,000 talents of refined silver, to overlay the walls of the houses withal, the gold for things of gold, and the silver for things of silver, and for all manner of work to be made by the hands of artificers. And who then is willing to consecrate his service this day unto the Lord?
Then the chief of the fathers and princes of the tribes of Israel, and the captains of thousands and of hundreds, with the rulers of the king's work, offered willingly, and gave for the service of the house of God, of gold 5,000 talents and 10,000 drams, and of silver 10,000 talents, and of brass 18,000 talents, and 100,000 talents of iron. And they with whom precious stones were found gave them to the treasure of the house of the Lord by the hand of Jehiel the Gershonite. Then the people rejoiced, for that they offered willingly, because with perfect heart they offered willingly to the Lord. And David the king also rejoiced with great joy. Wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation. And David said,
Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness, and the power, and the glory, and the victory, and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all. And in thine hand is power and might. And in thine hand it is to make great, and to give strength unto all. Now therefore, our God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name. But who am I, and what is my people, that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. For we are strangers before thee, and sojourners, as were all our fathers. Our days on the earth are as a shadow, and there is none abiding. O Lord our God, all this store that we have prepared to build thee an house for thine holy name cometh of thine hand, and is all thine own. I know also, my God, that thou triest the heart, and hast pleasure in uprightness. As for me, in the uprightness of mine heart I have willingly offered all these things. And now have I seen with joy thy people, which are present here, to offer willingly unto thee. O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, our fathers, keep this forever in the imagination of the thoughts of the heart of thy people, and prepare their heart unto thee. And give unto Solomon my son a perfect heart, to keep thy commandments, thy testimonies, and thy statutes, and to do all these things, and to build the palace for the which I have made provision.
And David said to all the congregation,
Now bless the Lord your God.
And all the congregation blessed the Lord God of their fathers, and bowed down their heads, and worshiped the Lord and the king. And they sacrificed sacrifices unto the Lord, and offered burnt offerings unto the Lord on the morrow after that day, even 1,000 bullocks, 1,000 rams, and 1,000 lambs, with their drink offerings, and sacrifices in abundance for all Israel, and did eat and drink before the Lord on that day with great gladness. And they made Solomon the son of David king the second time, and anointed him unto the Lord to be the chief governor, and Zadok to be priest. Then Solomon sat on the throne of the Lord as king, instead of David his father, and prospered, and all Israel obeyed him. And all the princes and the mighty men and all the sons likewise of King David submitted themselves unto Solomon the king. And the Lord magnified Solomon exceedingly in the sight of all Israel, and bestowed upon him such royal majesty as had not been on any king before him in Israel. Thus David the son of Jesse reigned over all Israel. And the time that he reigned over Israel was 40 years. 7 years reigned he in Hebron, and 33 years reigned he in Jerusalem. And he died in a good old age, full of days, riches, and honor. And Solomon his son reigned in his stead. Now the acts of David the king, first and last, behold, they are written in the book of Samuel the seer, and in the book of Nathan the prophet, and in the book of Gad the seer, with all his reign and his might, and the times that went over him, and over Israel, and over all the kingdoms of the countries. The end of the first book of the Chronicles. Psalm 127. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate.